Hi, we're starting chapter 11. Chapter 11, it's all about the current liabilities. In other words, it's the short-term liabilities, money that we owe to creditors within less than 1 year. There are a couple of examples in this chapter. This video is focused on the bonus. The reason it's considered a current liability, because usually companies, when they decide to pay bonus at the end of every year, usually it's percentage of the income they made during the year, and usually they pay that the following year. So let's say we are in 2017, we calculated the bonus, it was $10,000. We have to put that as a bonus expense in 2017, even though most probably we're gonna pay it sometime in 2018 to the employees. So that makes it a liability. The day we record that bonus expense in our books in 2017, and it's not gonna be paid immediately the same year, then we're gonna credit a liability account instead of cash. So here's an example in front of us. Assume that PDX company estimates that it will pay a 5% bonus on annual net income after deducting the bonus. Again, 5% bonus on the annual net income after deducting the bonus. Okay, so it's not, for example, whatever, $50,000 multiplied by 5% and then subtract the 5% out of the 50,000 to calculate your net income. No, it's 5% of the net income that was calculated after you already subtracted the bonus. We'll see how that works. So the company reports net income of $315,000 before the calculation of the bonus. So first, let's talk about the journal entry first, and then we will talk about how to calculate the amount. The journal entry, well, obviously we're gonna debit an expense account just like any other expense. It's called employee bonus expense. And the credit, because we're not paying cash in the same year as we discussed before, we will have to have a payable account. We're just gonna call it bonus payable or employee bonus payable, okay? Payable, so it's going to be under liabilities in the balance sheet. Now, how do we calculate the bonus? Let's make an equation. The equation that represents kind of the income statement. So in the income statement, we will have revenue minus expenses equals net income. Okay? So my net income is unknown, because the 315, it's the company's net income before the calculation of the bonus, okay? So to calculate my net income, I need to subtract so I have to do $315,000 minus bonus equals net income. Okay. All right. So if I know the relationship between those two, then we can update this formula a little bit so that we can calculate the bonus. So $315,000 minus, I'm just gonna consider the net income is the X. I'm just gonna put a variable here, it's X, okay? So here's my net income. So the bonus is 5% of X, right? It's 5% of X, or in other words, 0.05 X equals X, and then don't forget the 315,000. That's the best way to find out what your bonus is. 315,000 minus 5% of X equals X. And then basically you just need to solve for X. And then multiply the 5% by X to calculate your bonus. So to solve for X, it's algebra, I'm gonna move the X's, put them all in one place. So 315 equals X plus 0.05X. So 315,000 equals 1.05X. And then I just have to divide both sides by 1.05, cancel out, X equals, okay, so after canceling out the right side of the equation, then we get X, which is the net income, equals 315,000 divided by 1.05, that would be 300,000, that is my net income. So going back to the question, it tells us 5% bonus on annual net income after deducting the bonus. In other words, it's 5% of the 300,000. So bonus equals 5% multiplied by, gosh, this one's a little bit messed up, 5% multiplied by 300,000 equals $15,000. So in my Junon entry, debit employee bonus expense 15,000, credit employee bonus payable 15,000. And then next year when we pay it to the employees, then that payable account goes up to the debit side and the credit would be the cash of 15,000.